papers on today.
Oh!
This is Bobby Wygant, and we're ready to go.
Brad, we have never met before because this is your movie debut, but I feel like we're neighbors because I'm from Dallas-Fort Worth, and you're living in Louisville, I understand.
Right, right.
On the lake, or?
Right. We just, my wife and I, and my new little boy, he's 4 weeks old today, we just bought a house there.
So will you continue then to make that your base, or will you eventually have to move out here?
No, I keep a place out here too, but I've lived in the Lake Dallas Denton area for about 6 years now.
That was an outgrowth of your rodeo days?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
How did you do at the Fort Worth Rodeo?
The last time I competed at Fort Worth was in 86, I believe, maybe 87. And I made the finals in the calf rope and ended up not doing any good, but I did make it to the final round. But it's a great rodeo.
Could you ever have imagined at that time that you would be here in Los Angeles and now today talking about this movie Always, a Steven Spielberg movie with all these fabulous people?
Well, I never would. I mean, if you'd have told me that I was going to go to Hollywood, I would have told you that you were crazy. And actually, I backed into the business completely. I was at a rodeo in Wyoming, and they were casting a beer commercial. And they approached me about doing this commercial. And I said, well, I've got to go back down south. And in a couple of days, I won't be here. And they said, well, we can arrange to have you flown back up. And I thought, sure you can. This town's full of cowboys. You're going to fly me back up. And but they did. And then a year went by, and I started, I was approached about doing another spot, and I did it. And then I got hurt. I hurt my knee real bad, steer wrestling, at a rodeo. And the girl that I was dating at the time, who I eventually married, was a model for, she was modeling for Kim Dawson Agency out of Dallas.
And she's, what is her name?
Laura. She said maybe you should get an agent because you're going to have to earn a living, young man. And so I did. I went with Kim Dawson and did some commercials, and we did pretty well, and I decided to change my focus.
In this movie, you do an impression of John Wayne. It's part of your character. Was that something you had to learn, or have you always done John Wayne?
Oh, no, that was completely accidental. I was doing that impression for either Richard or John Goodman one day at lunch, and Stephen came over, and he said, do that again. And I did it, and he said, we're putting that in the movie. That's in the movie. So we axed all the lines that were in that particular scene, and in stepped John Wayne.
And what is it you say in the film again? What is the line?
Oh, you're going to have to go see the film again.
No, I want them to hear you. Just.
Oh, I can't
just say
do it for you.
I
can't do
John
it
Wayne.
For you. No.
Anyway, it's pretty good. It's pretty
well,
good.
Well, thank you.
Yes. I understand also that when you first met Kathleen Kennedy, the producer, that was an infamous day for you.
Yeah, here it comes. I was introduced to Kathleen, who is a producer, by Laura Kennedy, the casting director, and there's no relation between the two. Well, Laura left Kathleen and I together in a room for a meeting, and I called Kathleen Laura for the rest of the meeting, and she was nice enough to not say anything about it. And then we did the screen test with Holly Hunter, and then I had another meeting with her some weeks later. I wanted to be sure and not call her Laura again. I was so concerned. You know, I saw her and I went right over to her and I said, Kathleen, nice to see you. And I had a Dr. Pepper and I spilled it all over. I mean, all over her pants and her shoes. And ended up accidentally getting the part in spite of it. So.
Well, it was the klutziness that really helped you, wasn't it?
Well, it says my character, Ted Baker, is a little klutzy, and it was a little spooky how easily it came to me.
Brad, what was it like for you the first day that you had to be on the set actually doing scenes with these people?
Well, they made me feel very, very comfortable, you know, and I knew they made it really clear up front that if I needed any help, I could go to them. Steven made me feel that way, as well as the rest of the cast. I felt some pressure on myself because I wanted to do a good job. That was my main concern, that I did a good job and that I met the expectations of the people that hired me, as well as my own expectations.
What did you come away after you finished the film? What did you come away with?
Well, you know, obviously a lot of experience. It was great to sit back and watch the likes of Richard Dreyfuss, Holly Hunter, John Goodman, you know, and watch them work. And I learned a lot from them. I think probably just learning to listen is probably what I learned. And Stephen told me, he said, don't act. Don't ever act. Just do what you do, and you'll be all right.
And you are all right. You're more than all right. You're good. Brad, I've enjoyed talking with you, and I hope that maybe our paths will cross sometime out there on the lake, maybe.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you. Nice and
stop tape.
Thank you.
Your goat ropers on today.
Oh!
This is Bobby Wygant, and we're ready to go.
Brad, we have never met before because this is your movie debut, but I feel like we're neighbors because I'm from Dallas-Fort Worth, and you're living in Louisville, I understand.
Right, right.
On the lake, or?
Right, we just, my wife and I, and my new little boy, he's 4 weeks old today. We just bought a house there.
So will you continue then to make that your base, or will you eventually have to move out here?
No, I keep a place out here too, but I've lived in the Lake Dallas Denton area for about 6 years now.
That was an outgrowth of your rodeo days?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
How did you do at the Fort Worth Rodeo?
The last time I competed at Fort Worth was in 86, I believe, maybe 87, and I made the finals in the calf rope and ended up not doing any good, but I did make it to the final round. But it's a great rodeo.
Could you ever have imagined at that time that you would be here in Los Angeles and now today talking about this movie, Always, a Steven Spielberg movie with all these fabulous people?
Well, I never would. I mean, if you'd have told me that I was going to go to Hollywood, I would have told you that you were crazy. And actually, I backed into the business completely. I was at a rodeo in Wyoming, and they were casting a beer commercial, and they approached me about doing this commercial. And I said, well, I've got to go back down south, and in a couple days I won't be here. And they said, well, we can arrange to have you flown back up. And I thought, sure you can. This town's full of cowboys. You're going to fly me back up. And but they did. And then a year went by, and I started, I was approached about doing another spot, and I did it. And then I got hurt. I hurt my knee real bad, steer wrestling at a rodeo. And the girl that I was dating at the time, who I eventually married, was a model for, she was modeling for Kim Dawson Agency out of Dallas.
And she's, what is her name?
Laura. And she said maybe you should get an agent because you're going to have to earn a living, young man. And so I did. I went with Kim Dawson and did some commercials, and we did pretty well, and I decided to change my focus.
In this movie, you do an impression of John Wayne. It's part of your character. Was that something you had to learn, or have you always done John Wayne?
Oh, no, that was completely accidental. I was doing that impression for either Richard or John Goodman one day at lunch, and Stephen came over and he said, do that again. And I did it, and he said, we're putting that in the movie. That's in the movie. So we axed all the lines that were in that particular scene, and in stepped John Wayne.
And what is it you say in the film again? What is the line?
Oh, you're going to have to go see the film again.
No, I want them to hear you. Just.
Oh, I can't
just say
do
one
it for you.
Thing
I can't do it
Wayne.
For you. No.
Anyway, it's pretty good. It's pretty
good.
Well,
thank you.
Yes. I understand also that when you first met Kathleen Kennedy, the producer, that was an infamous day for you.
Yeah, here it comes. I was introduced to Kathleen, who is a producer, by Laura Kennedy, the casting director, and there's no relation between the two. Well, Laura left Kathleen and I together in a room for a meeting, and I called Kathleen Laura for the rest of the meeting. And she was nice enough to not say anything about it. And then we did the screen test with Holly Hunter, and then I had another meeting with her some weeks later. I wanted to be sure and not call her Laura again. I was so concerned. You know, I saw her, and I went right over to her, and I said, "Kathleen, nice to see you." And I had a Dr. Pepper, and I spilled it all over. I mean, all over her pants and her shoes, and ended up accidentally getting the part in spite of it.
Well, it was the klutziness that really helped you, wasn't it?
Well, it says my character, Ted Baker, is a little klutzy, and it was a little spooky how easily it came to me.
Right. What was it like for you the first day that you had to be on the set actually doing scenes with these people?
Well, they made me feel very, very comfortable, you know, and I knew they made it really clear up front that if I needed any help, I could go to them. Steven made me feel that way, as well as the rest of the cast. I felt some pressure on myself because I wanted to do a good job. That was my main concern, that I did a good job and that I met the expectations of the people that hired me, as well as my own expectations.
What did you come away after you finished the film? What did you come away with?
Well, you know, obviously a lot of experience. It was great to sit back and watch the likes of Richard Dreyfuss, Holly Hunter, John Goodman, you know, and watch them work. And I learned a lot from them. I think probably just learning to listen is probably what I learned. And Stephen told me, he said, don't act. Don't ever act. Just do what you do, and you'll be all right.
And you are all right. You're more than all right. You're good. Brad, I've enjoyed talking with you, and I hope that maybe our paths will cross sometime out there on the lake, maybe.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you. Nice.
Stop tape.
Thank you.